Hello. One day, a father and his son were walking their donkey to the market to sell it off. On the way, some girls who were passing by saw them and commented, "This father and son must be foolish, for what is a donkey to ride on it, isn't it?" The father thought that the girls were right, and he made his son ride the donkey. As they went a little further, some elderly men came along the way and they remarked, "Look at that lazy boy, isn't he ashamed? He is comfortably riding on the donkey and making his old father walk." This appeared reasonable to the two. So the son got down from the donkey and started walking, and the father mounted on the donkey and started riding. As they went farther on, some women who came along the road rebuked the father. "You are such a heartless man. How can you comfortably ride on the donkey and make your poor little boy walk in the hot blazing sun?" Then the father made the boy also mount on the donkey. As they went on and on, some people who saw the father and the son, both of them riding the donkey, started making jeers at them, started making jokes at them. When the father asked the people why they were behaving like that, the people shouted at him, "Have you no sense? Don't you see the donkey is being overloaded by the weight of the both of you? How can you be so ruthless to a poor animal?" This, the father and the son thought, was absolutely right. And so they thought and thought as to what to do now. The son came up with an idea. He suggested, instead of being carried by the donkey, they should carry the donkey. The father agreed. They tied the legs of the donkey, lifted it on a pole, and began carrying it. After a while, they reached a narrow bridge. While crossing that bridge, the donkey became very frightened and it started to struggle very violently, and in that chaos, it kicked the back of the boy. The boy lost his balance. In turn, the father also lost his balance, and all three of them fell into the river. The people who saw this accident came running and rescued the father and the son. But the donkey could not be rescued. Since its legs were tied, it had drowned away. Different people have different ideas and opinions about the same thing. It might be a futile attempt to please them all. Welcome to Kathayana. Today's video is dedicated to World Mental Health Day, which is observed on 10th of October every year. The theme for 2018 is Young People and Mental Health in the Changing World. The story I just narrated is a famous Aesop's fable, which is relevant to even to this date and time. The youngsters who seek to establish their own identity, those who feel a constant pressure of meeting the expectations of their family and society, those who feel the odd challenges of staying abreast with the latest trends in fashion and technology, and those who fear of being judged by their peers and friends, changing societal values, urbanization, migration, and several other factors are leading many young people to behave like the father and the son in that story, to please all those who they meet along the way. And without any knowledge, without being aware of what is actually happening, the young people are slowly drowning into mental illnesses like depression, anxiety, addiction, either to substances or social media. NIMHANS in Bengaluru conducted a national mental health survey in 2015 and 16 in 12 states of India and reported that common mental disorders like depression, neurosis, and substance abuse are a huge unrecognized burden in mental health. And these problems are higher in urban metro regions as compared to rural and urban non-metro areas. Among adolescents aged from 13 years to 17 years, the most frequent mental disorders observed are anxiety disorders and mood disorders. Another team of researchers conducted a research with 177 students as participants from an Indian university to ascertain the level of depression and its association with perceived parameters. And what was found was 53% of the students suffered from depression. Female students reported more depression than their counterparts. This study also disclosed that those students who held positive views about their university academic environment and living arrangements had low levels of depression than their counterparts. Personal resilience, being able to share personal problems with others, and doing regular exercise contributed majorly to the positive mental health of the students. So if anyone is suffering from a mental illness like depression or anxiety, is there a way out? There are many ways out. I will now tell you a true story of a young college student who suffered from depression, coped with her illness, and came out of it. I will name her Devi because this year World Mental Health Day has coincided with Navratri festivities in India. During Navratri, we celebrate the victory of a goddess over a demon. The ignorance, the taboos, and the struggles associated with mental illness are no less demons. Devi, the college student, was always a pessimist. She had a low self-esteem and would always criticize herself. Her negative thought patterns laid a foundation upon which hundreds of tiny incidents built upon and made home for depression. Devi was staying in Australia away from her parents, where she was studying third year of her college. At that time, she had a heavy workload, attending class discussions, writing assignments and submitting it on time, giving paper presentations in class, the typical college life. But Devi was stressed out with the workload. She was anxious of meeting with the tight deadlines. Devi was also insecure about her future because the scholarship application that she had applied at the university was rejected 3 times. Due to all this stress, Devi began to isolate herself from her friends. She reduced the social activities that she used to have with them. And the home that Devi was staying at was also demotivating. She was living in a basement apartment that did not allow natural light to come in. And once, when Devi had visited her home to celebrate her birthday with her family, one of her parents had told her that they could not stand to look at her, and it's better she does not come home again, because if she did, she is sure to make everyone in the house unhappy. This made Devi feel worthless. One by one, all of these incidents accumulated in her mind and made Devi feel very miserable. She simply stopped caring for herself. And there came a point when Devi found it difficult to even wake up in the morning. She found it sloggy to get out of bed and do her work. She would simply lie in bed for hours and go to college later and later, thus missing attending college on time. And gradually, she even entirely stopped going to college and felt that she would go to college only when it was absolutely necessary for her to go. This was a strategy to avoid facing another day. Devi also found it tedious to do household chores like cooking, eating, and cleaning the house. She would eat just one meal a day and would not bother to clean up the utensils that were piling up in the kitchen sink. On the other side, Devi's friends noticed her long absence from college and got worried. So they went to meet Devi to learn what happened. When her friends met her, Devi told them how difficult she was feeling to wake up in the morning and eat food. Her friends got concerned and asked her to visit a doctor soon. But Devi did not agree immediately. She refused. She just let it be because she simply did not want to care for herself. But in spite of her strong reproach, Devi's friends stood by her for 2 months, persistently urging her to go visit a doctor and seek professional help. And it was only after 2 months that Devi visited a doctor. And then things started seeming better for Devi. She was, of course, prescribed some medicines. Along with that, it was the therapy sessions which Devi attended regularly that helped her a lot to learn about herself and her life. In these therapy sessions, Devi learned that thoughts are just thoughts. They are not the reality, no matter how real they may seem. And that mistakes are just mistakes that happen. They do not indicate a failure on her part. Rather, they are chances to learn and grow. Devi was extremely grateful to her friends who stood by her. She understood that her friends persistently urged her to go to visit a doctor because they genuinely cared for her. One of her friends even helped Devi to move out of her dungeon-like apartment to a house which had windows in all the rooms. The natural light, the fresh air made Devi feel very good about her environment that she was staying in. Devi says, try to reach out to people and accept their help. This way, you will make yourself and the people who care about you feel better. However, the medications and the therapy sessions that Devi was taking did not work magically. Devi did not come out of her depression at the snap of a finger. Devi was still finding it difficult to wake up in the morning and go to work. But Devi remained patient throughout her treatment and she followed the professional advice. She broke down a task into small subtasks and accomplished each of them one by one, thus avoiding being overwhelmed looking at the big picture. So, when she woke up in the morning, instead of dreading to do and complete so much work, she would simply push herself to get out of bed. Once that task was completed, she would force herself into the bathroom to take a bath. Once the bathing task was completed, she would pull herself inside the kitchen to prepare something to eat. And once that task was completed, she would force herself to go out, go to college. She practiced this way, and slowly she started feeling better. Devi took up art classes. She also resumed her volunteering service with an organization which she had left due to her depression. Getting back to doing work, doing what she liked, and being of some help to others made Devi feel very good about herself because she was doing something that was consistent with her personal values. That made her feel like a part of something bigger than herself. She had found some purpose. And this way, in 1 year, Devi was in a much better mental space. Along with the medications and the therapy sessions, Devi practiced one wonderful technique. You know what that is? Self-compassion. Self-compassion means giving ourselves the same kindness and care as we would give to a good friend. There are research-based evidence that prove that self-compassion is a helpful tool to enjoy good mental health. Dr. Kristen Neff is a leading expert on self-compassion and she has conducted pioneering research on self-compassion for over a decade. Dr. Neff defines self-compassion as a useful emotional strategy in which painful or distressing feelings are not avoided, but are held in awareness with kindness and understanding and a sense of humanity. If you want to learn more about the facts presented in this video, do check out the links in the description box. Here's a disclaimer. The contents in this video and the references in the description box are meant for awareness and information purposes only. They do not intend to provide any sort of medical advice for mental illness. So if you or someone who you know is suffering from a mental illness and looking for professional advice or a medical treatment, reach out to certified mental health counselors or psychiatrists. If you like this video, share it in your circles to raise awareness on the topic of mental health. Mental illness is nothing to be ashamed of. It needs to be given the same attention as is given to a physical illness. This is Lakshmi taking your leave. See you all soon.